Have you ever looked up in the sky and seen an airplane's contrails like this and wondered, how do the pilots not hit each other? It's probably not what you think. I'll explain it all. Coming up. Hey 7-4 crew, welcome back. If you don't know me, my name's Kelsey. I'm a 747 pilot. My channel, 7-4 Gear, is all about aviation. So whether you're a pilot or an aviation enthusiast, consider subscribing. I'm making this video because someone left a YouTube comment asking, how do the planes avoid hitting each other in the sky? So if you ever have any aviation questions, just leave them in the comment section below. But how the pilots avoid hitting each other is nothing crazy like,
I lost him, Goose.
I'm looking. I got him. He's on our tail, coming hard.
Yeah, I got him.
All right, let's get into it. First, we get assistance from ATC. ATC is air traffic control. When you fly in a commercial flight, the pilots are on a specific type of flight plan that allows them to fly at higher altitudes and also fly through clouds. It also means that we have an entire team on the ground, air traffic control, which is assisting us with our flight. Air traffic control does a lot of different things, but one of them is looking at our aircraft and all the aircraft that are around us and making sure that there is no possibility of a collision.
Well, that seems like a logical idea.
But since humans make mistakes regardless of how perfect they think they are, some additional measures have been put in place for safety. Another way we avoid mid-air collisions is that we fly at different altitudes depending on the direction of flight. If your aircraft is flying east, you're gonna be flying at an odd altitude. So you might be at 31,000 or 33,000 or 37,000 feet. If you're flying west, you're gonna be at an even altitude, 36,000, 38,000 feet. More specifically, imagine a compass being 360 degrees. If you're flying on any heading from 0 to 179 degrees, you're gonna be flying at an easterly altitude. So an odd altitude, 33 or 35,000 as an example. If your aircraft is flying from 180 degrees to 359 degrees, you're gonna be flying at an even altitude. By doing that, there is another barrier to prevent accidents in flight. Another feature we have is something called TCAS. TCAS stands for Traffic Collision Avoidance System. Technically, commercial aircrafts have a more advanced system called TCAS 2. It's a newer version. And in that, the airplane systems are talking to each other. Hypothetically, if you have two aircraft on a collision course,
holy shit, we're head to head. I can't believe we're doing this.
The TCAS systems are going to talk to each other. They're going to say to one aircraft, climb. The other aircraft is going to get told to descend. And that's going to increase the safety margins while you're in the air. What will happen is there will be a warning to the pilots and it will tell them, climb or descend. The pilots at that time will disconnect the autopilot and the TCAS usually will give them a amount of descent that's needed to avoid a collision. It's actually one of the very few times that the pilots can change an altitude without requesting permission from air traffic control. And also, it's one of the few times they can disregard an instruction from air traffic control.
You're not the boss of me!
Once the pilots have completed that maneuver, the TCAS will let them know that they're safe. At that point, they'll contact air traffic control and let them know exactly what happened. All right, crew, that's three different ways that the pilots avoid mid-air collisions in flight. In the comment section below, I want you to let me know. Do you like the idea when there's a TCAS alert that the pilots are hand-flying the aircraft? Or do you think the autopilot should make the corrections? I look forward to hearing from you. Until then, keep the blue side up.